ice. We're having a fish out here, man. We're gonna be fishing inside the heat of that. It's supposed to be warm. It's my first time here. Let's go. Ooh, it's cold. Walk this way. Oh, no, no, no. Not too fast. $6, huh? Gotta go inside, pay first. Let's go inside.
Yeah, I fish this quite a bit too. Just with the boat.
We've got,
yeah, that's what we're doing. I really like fishing down there because there's plenty of places to fish. Like, people don't realize you can spoonbill at the damn firm.
Really?
Spoonbill fish, yeah. I caught 7 of them in an afternoon down there.
Down there at the park?
Yep. That's right. I caught a 45.5 pound flathead out there.
I like going down to John Redmond down in Pensacola.
That's not bad. I'm just on a big catfishing. I just seen
Well, you can catch the shit out of crappie and white bass down in there.
Yeah. There's a lot of walleye and sauger in there as well.
Never caught any of those. You can get into that bee down there, and it's like down below the spillway, follow the spillway back into the V where it creek and the spillway run. Right at the tip of that V over by that dock, you push a shoe out of the property.
That's
what I heard. They have a little bit of water running.
I heard that. I've never really gone down there to fish. I went down and looked at it the other day, so now I know where it's at. I'll go out.
Throw the lights out?
Yeah, I put a. Here's what I like to do. I even do it at Hillsdale. I'll go up there and I'll put in there on the campground area over there.
Yeah.
And I'll put in right there and I'll just go out into that little bit of timber that's right there. And I'll put a lantern on a pole on one of those trees and I'll back off it about 15 or 18 feet, cast to it, and let it fall back to me. You can wear them out doing that.
Yeah, they're going to be
the fish in Hillsdale's been getting a lot bigger since they started that. I remember you just go out there and there's 9-inch fish all fucking day long.
What's the limit out of here?
It's 20.
20.
Yeah, I figured there's still 10.
The walleye are 18. They're 18 inches.
But see, you could go out there and catch 18-inch fish.
I've got a lot of 15s last year for walleye. Couldn't catch any 20s or 18s or 19s.
You switch over to crankbait fishing and deep water.
I'm going to have to try that. I need to learn. I watched a lot of videos, and I thought I was doing it right. There's all the claw rigs and stuff. I do catch fish, but nothing big. And that crab, I'm not going to attack. And there was more coming in, but we got some of that coming on that. 10 boats in Hillsdale or 20 boats, maybe.
There's some saying here, 3 or 5.
There's just so many different places we go.
If you spot lock it, you'd be right there when you.
Within a 5 foot area. I love it, man. That's just one of the greatest things. I really do.
I really love this storm coming in my bed.
Holy shit, that's a big one.
Where's that?
Oh, that's a shad.
It is.
That's good to
see here. I love seeing shad in here. Might get some bigger crappie on the right here if you start seeing shad. That's what we have not seen a shad in here. That's one of the first ones I've seen. I caught it early on. But I've been fishing up here every Saturday since the middle of December. And I have caught 9 keepers.
That whole time,
yeah.
It's always slow when I come down here.
And
really
I come
small.
Down here, I came down here the last weekend of December, and I bet you in 5 hours I caught 300 fish. You could drop your line over without catching one of them little summer bands.
Last year we came, there was like tons of crappie just on top of water.
Yep.
Little ones, tons.
You know that a crappie can have between 6,000 and 60,000 eggs?
Wow.
And they say 1% of that survives. So if a crappie lays 60, yeah, that's it. That's the there. And you know how long a crappie lives? 6 years.
Yeah,
6 years.
So there's some crappie that live longer, that can live longer, but the average crappie lifespan is 6 years. So what we're catching today is year-old fish.
Pretty much.
Year-old fish, yeah.
Yeah,
I want something 4 or 5 years.
Yeah, look at that one.
I want the fat sister right now.
I want a grandma and grandpa.
I want a great grandma and grandma.
Hey, he's, serious,
he's getting greedy.
Get that old timer.
Yeah. See, I just like to do this. My wife can't understand how I can come out here and set for 6 hours, 7 hours and do this. It's a good conversation. It's fun to talk.
I could just sit all day long.
Bring on lunch, baby.
Yeah, it's not like you can go outside and do anything.
Netflix.
Yeah. Lots of fishing videos.
Yeah. Not Netflix.
You got 2 hours pulling of that?
10 minutes of pulling and 8 hours of fishing videos.
Yeah. That's the other thing I get in trouble for.
Pulling and fishing videos.
Watch, how many deer can you watch get shot? All day long? Flashlights were dying. Came back out at 10 o'clock and we jumped him. And where he was laying, the blood pile was, the blood circuit was about 3.5 feet. So he lost a shit ton of blood.
Yeah.
And we decided to let him go and come back and get him. Well, we tracked it till it hit the river. And it was like, oh shit, he went into the river. The guy said he shot it right on the other side of the river, right where it went across.
He seen it on the river and went up and grabbed it.
And that's what makes me sick. It's like, I know in my heart that he didn't shoot.
People do crazy shit.
Really nice if he gave it up.
Yeah. People do a lot of stuff for him.
They've been feeding for a couple years.
And then they say that, hey man, we got this deer off our property. Come shoot a deer here. $3,000, come shoot a deer.
Well, it's funny you say that because the guy that owns the property is going to lease it and shit. You know,
well, they make too much money off of it, not to.
So that tiny area is done for me. But I got nothing.
They're making it in Kansas where you can start buying tags and giving them to people. Like, I don't know, it's a big thing about it.
No, I drop her down close to the 10, 12. If I get a knock in front of my buddy, I don't want my body.
same time.
What's the 14 and 15 inch? Don't know what those are. Didn't want to even come close.
That's because he's got on her. We're going to keep her top of the damn thing.
We'll put them together right there.
This weather will move them in.
Keeper. Oh, that's close to good. That was almost it. I had it all morning, so you were close. I think I still had it. That one I caught was like again.
You should mention that other one.
How did it came up.
Yeah, it's normal. get off the light bulb. I see people ice skating there last year in the cave over here.
Oh, really?
Yep. A couple of kids.
I like the ice fish, but ice can sketch me off.
Catch one?
I went to Gilsville the other day during that last big freak we had. And some guy was out there, they were gone. He had holes from the bank. You do a multiple holes. Somebody's testing the ice.
Catch the biggest one, get the prize. At the end of the day. Anybody go try John Rittman yet?
Where?
John Rittman?
No.
No.
I've kind of bunched down there in that spillway back there. Where it V's off.
There's that got one.
Gets Island. Fished a lot, and I don't know if they're getting a lot of fish, but right now they got trout in there.
Oh, hot stuff.
Everybody's trout fishing.
Everywhere.
They stocked it either. Yeah, I think it was last week.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Have
you
got a trout
stand
for that?
I think
they
do.
They have yellow perch in there.
Yeah, I heard they did put them in there.
Yeah, I was saying that they had.
Actually,
breathing away.
Smoke, that's it.
Okay, forget it. He's got hanged over there now.
I just switched my knees. I was waiting for that one to break off.
Shit, I was trying to cut some shad. I was down there at the waterfall at the lake. I'm sure we're throwing that out. I caught some Asian carp in there, but they haven't really pulled in. They're all waterfall.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Crazy.
Oh, my God. I bet there's 1,000 of them in there, all 5-6 inches long.
Oh, my God.
I mean, there's a few shad in there, but not very
good. Where are they going to be in 10 years?
Oh. You can go down there in the springtime when they're running, and you can catch hundreds of them. I mean, they'll buy a bird up.
They're a lot bigger. I've seen some 20 pounders pull out of
them.
What's
going on? They don't look like them. They call them big mouth sharks, or lizard sharks.
I've never caught them, so I don't know.
There are those fish that you see people driving down the Mississippi, and they're like jumping up in the air and flying people's boats.
I heard them get hurt. Pretty bad. What you got on the tree shaking and switch over?
That would be fun.
Try.
Jump in the boat and try to slice them at the same time.
Shotgun?
No, the fruit ninja.
The performance key shooting.
Yeah.
I tell you, the best job I ever seen was the game warden. It was in Arizona. Their job was at night. You get in the back of the truck with a couple of lawn chairs, 22 rifle, and they would drive up and down this river, this creek bank, and shoot these varmints that were burrowing in the banks. I can't remember what they called them, varmints, but they were considered as a pest. And there was a governor. They were in lawn chairs. Man, that's a job I don't want.
What is that, like the ground
crawl
or the ground?
And it's, I can't remember what it's called, right? But it's something that burrows into the in the waterways and the dams of it.
Muskrat? Muskrat? Yeah.
Muskrat,
maybe?
It's a muskrat family, but they call it something else. And I guess it really reproduces a lot. But the game warden's job was that night was to shoot them things. Bob Lytle, shoot them with 22.
That's kind of fun, though.
Oh, that would be a blast, dude. I'd love that. Big job had. You have a couple of beers while you do it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm
going to
try this one. I've seen in Texas, you go drive around in a helicopter and you can shoot hogs.
Hogs, yeah, that's a huge big
thing. It's like a huge machine gun, a little like this. Drive around and shoot for like $1,100. It's like an hour. You can go fly around for an hour and shoot hogs.
Once you're done, you got big ass harvest.
Yeah.
Over.
Yeah. It wouldn't suck.
Pick up pieces of it.
You would not suck at all.
I always snip the fins off them. I don't have to worry about pulling them out of the bucket. These little bastards will sting the shit out of you.
Creek job, that's what I like to use.
Hell yeah, I like creek job number one.
I can't even end that bastards.
You know what, 8 to 10 inches?
I know a couple of creeks you can go get those.
They're hard to find anymore.
Get everybody in your mama one of
them. Don't tell my buddy, because.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm just going to find a football. They used to have to go by.
There's still a couple of
them. Yeah, you got to go to creeks.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, we all grew up going down the creeks, man. No, I'm not going to pick
them. I got some good spots out by Rantoul and shit.
Hey, you're going to go ponds up at Rantoul, dude. Damn good pond.
Some good creeks up there. A bunch of rocks farming. Just drop them right in front of the rocks and just get pulled out of the rocks and grab them. A little chunk of a worm. You see some little fish here at night.
I think they're close to 8 or something up there.
Six.
A long time ago, I used to go to fish.
Yeah,
a long time ago.
Yeah, they're going to. He was talking about maybe start. This summer, he may start staying open late, and then he's maybe talking about next winter, wintertime, or nighttime. I told him, I said, if he wanted somebody to run his place for nighttime for him, I'd do it. I'd quit my job and do this. I'd vote, but I'd have to have a hole inside.
Right? Yeah,
fish where I was waiting for business.
Right behind the counter.
Yep.
And if you see some dunchits coming up here that are all wasted, you know?
Yeah.
That's where the problem came in last time. Kids came in here and pulled away.
Yeah.
They cut every single tree off every dog. They came in here and threw the stove in the water.
I'd love to cop them kids.
Threw the stove in the water?
Yeah.
It used to be it wasn't run at night. You'd just come in and fish.
Oh, really?
It was on the open during the day.
Ruined that, didn't it?
Yep, ruined it sure as shit.
Yeah, you could take a big giant slap dropping around between 12 and 2 o'clock in the morning.
That's what I heard.
That's why I start catching flatheads after midnight.
And you get some nice walleye in here too this after dark. And then white some bring all them shadding.
That's right. I love that.
Mess around with it. I need to do that.
That same trolling motor is another feature. We're talking about hinge three. It's called a north button. Like you see the center path one, you want to go straight.
Right.
Well, you get that north button and it will put you on that path, even though your nose is going like this. The wind blowing it, it keeps it under your nose.
That'd be great.
Yeah, it is. It makes it that much more hands free.
I need it.
But you know, they don't know what below the water is.
All around that tree.
I thought somebody was walking over there. It's late. Ooh, so nice. fish out here too if you want.